All right, boys, what's going on? How you doing? We got Peter in here, Phil's in here, Mo, what up, Nils, Carson, Mr. Black, BB7's in here, Gurvinder, M. Ginger, Harman's in here, Sean G, Peter Piper, Gokul's in here, Gervish, we got a lot of people today. What's up, Vladdy, how you doing? So let's go over this quick. We got the indexes to start. I don't know how clear the screen is. I got a bigger monitor, so let me know how it is. SPY, a lot of volatility today. As we told you over the weekend, September is known to be one of the weaker months in the stock market. That's why we haven't been taking as many plays. We are loaded in Amazon. That's why I was sitting tight most of the day, other than selling PayPal and jumping in TAL. Other than that, we're just managing what we got already. There's a pattern in the stock market. September is known for weakness. Last September was awful. September before that, I think, was really bad as well. But yeah, right off the bat, you guys seen, we took out the pre-market lows on SPY right away, which signaled weakness right away. Complete dump, right? You see this little red line here? Why did I know this was the bottom, and why did I jump in SPY calls? If you zoom out to the daily on SPY, you see the 8-day moving average. That's where I marked the red lines. At the 8-day moving average, which is support, and I marked a red line at the all-time high, which was resistance today. So as soon as you have those daily reminders, you see how easy it is? Came right down, tested it, big bounce. Came right down, tested it, big bounce. So that's what I was watching for that part. So I jumped in the SPY 452 calls. They actually went in the money. I sold a little bit early, but it is what it is. Other than that, on the daily, we're still bullish. Everything's still bullish. There's no reason to panic at all yet. But it is September. Manage your positions, don't be too heavy. Have some cash on hand. If in case we get another dip like this, you wanna be buying calls at the bottom of this channel. So if you don't have cash, you're not gonna be able to do anything. You're not gonna be able to take opportunity. So when it arises. So just keep cash on hand, manage your account. Not too much risk in September, please, but it is your money, do whatever the hell you want. I will go over TAL, don't worry. I have two tabs. I was actually gonna do it like this. I don't know if it's cleaner like this. You just go like that, whatever, we'll see it. All right, so QQQ, strongest sector today. Strongest sector, obviously tech. Complete in the morning, we're just chopping around, pre-market high, pre-market low, dump down underneath, and then we rip back above. Tech was the strongest sector today. It was the only one that closed above its pre-market high. On the daily, if you zoom out, I did the same thing. Red line at the 8-day moving average, red line at the all-time highs. We took out the all-time highs at one point today by 7 cents, but we did close underneath it. So keep an eye on that. That's still resistance. Today's high turns into the new resistance on QQQ. But tech is the strongest sector, and that's why we still have our Amazon. Other than that, banks were just a big turd today. Banks and small caps completely shit the bed. 5-minute chart, you can see we closed at the low of the day. Very ugly candle on the daily. Very ugly setup completely. You guys see this little wedge was forming before ascending wedge. It looks like we broke it to the downside. Closed below all the moving averages. The next moving average down is 37.27, which would be a really deep drop on XLF. If you know how XLF moves, 60 cent drop is a big thing. Other than that, we broke out of the pattern. Everything looks bearish to me on XLF. Financials are a non-touch right now. And everything looks like it's rotating from banks into tech. So keep an eye on that. IWM, another one, closed at the low of the day, complete dump. Weakest of the day was small caps. You can use IWM, you can use RUT, you can use whatever you want. Small caps are weak. And like I told you guys last week, small caps usually lead the market. Off the bottom, they rip the most up, and off the top, they dump the most down. So if small caps are this weak, if we do not hold the 8-day moving average on small caps, which is at 225.86. Tomorrow, if we close below 225.86, which is the 8-day moving average, I think the whole market is due for consolidation then. I think SPY consolidates, I think QQQ consolidates, if IWM closes below the 8-day moving average tomorrow. If we bounce tomorrow on IWM, it means the market goes higher in my opinion. And right now, it's way too obvious that the market's gonna dump in September in my opinion. There's way too many people online saying, calling for a dump, September's weak, this and that, blah, blah, blah. So in my opinion, we might run a little bit more before dumping just to suck more people in, but it is possible we dump from here. Especially with XLF this week, SPY will be really hard for SPY to go up with XLF this week, despite QQQ being so strong. So keep an eye on those three sectors, four sectors, IWM as well. We need that one to reverse. ES, So ES futures, I had these resistance support lines drawn out. We actually closed below a critical support that I had at 45. 452050 was a critical support that we needed to hold, but we closed below it. Let's see if we can get back above it and hold it tomorrow. If we cannot, more downside to come. 450475 is the next support. BTC, the name of the video. Why did I say shakeout? El Salvador said they're accepting Bitcoin. And right off the bat, we dropped from 47,832, we dropped to 42,900. So we dropped 5,000 plus. We dropped 5,000 points in Bitcoin in 5 minutes. You guys want those quick volatile gains up? You got to be ready for those quick volatile moves down as well. My line in the sand on Bitcoin is 46,000. It remains 46,000. As long as we close today, there's 3 hours and 50 minutes left in today's candle. 3 hours, 50 minutes, we need to close above 46,000 or I will be trimming a lot of my Bitcoin that I bought down here at 31,000. Okay, 46,000 must hold in my opinion. We'll do CPNG on this one because I just remembered, someone reminded me. CPNG actually, so today was a very, very nice day, don't get me wrong. But what is this? This is the ugliest chart ever. We IPO'd around 69 bucks.
Ooh, came. About 30 bucks.
What is?
Coop,
$30.
Hoof? Coop.
C-O-U-P. Oh, Coop. Okay, yeah.
$30.
Yeah, that's a really good cloud company. Straight from the IPO, we just started a downtrend. We've never been able to break that downtrend. What's happening here is just lower highs, lower low, lower high, lower low. And now do we set another lower high? The only way to change the daily trend now is to get all the way up to $40.10. So this could all just be squiggle. This could turn into an equilibrium. How do we change the daily trend on CPNG? We have to set a higher low and then a higher high and then a higher low and then a higher high. So it's going to take time to change the trend on CPNG, which is why I said wait for confirmation. Today looks great. We closed above the 21-day moving average, which is awesome, amazing. But this one ran 9.78% today. So it was very hard to jump in a stock that's up 9% already. We need to change the trend. Right now, it's still working on the 4-hour trend. So what it did was higher or lower high, lower high, lower low again. We didn't set a lower low, actually. Hold on, give me 1 second. Okay, so this is this. We're trying to change the 4-hour trend on CPNG right now. We put in a lower low, we put in a lower high, and now we put in a higher low and a higher high. So it's trying to change the trend on the 4-hour. The next time it dips, we need to hold this low right here. This low of 29.21. 29.21, if we hold it, if we put in a low higher than that, it looks like it's changing the trend on the 4-hour. After it changes the trend on the 4-hour back to uptrend, we have to change it on the daily. Same story. We have to hold 29.21, set a higher low, and then we have to break this high of today, which is 32.79. So we need to change the trend. It's going to take a while. There's no rush in this one. I would wait for confirmation just because it's been so weak for so long. Let's go on to the other ones here. Roku, absolutely love this setup. I've seen so many times. You guys have no idea. So a stock will completely dump, right? People think this is a low. It can't go any lower. It starts moving up, sucks everyone in, and then breaks the low to take everyone's stop losses out, and then it rips. So what Roku doing right now is exactly that. It set the low. Now everyone that jumped in long anywhere after August 19th, anyone that went long, they probably had their stop loss under this day, which was at 340. Yesterday or Friday, we flushed those people out, got their stop losses, and today hammer candle. Friday, strong day, strong recovery. And today hammer candle, let's see if we can get continuation. I really, really like this setup. Roku is known to run very, very fast. So keep an eye on this Roku. I like it all the way to the 50-day moving average, which is at 399. We can go all the way to 399, but first we have to clear the other moving averages. We have 363, 399 as resistances on Roku. Plus we have a big volume shelf here, so there's a lot of people buying and selling here. It's gonna be hard, it's gonna move slowly. Moderna called it to a T. We took the $400 calls last week because it closed over my level. It shook me out with that news. But look at this. Amazing. If you guys go on the Discord in the premium channels, type in LB MSL watch list this morning. You can check how many of those stocks that I sent this morning that actually ripped today. And you can make your own judgment. That was sent at like 7 a.m. So go take a look. Next time I send a watch list, make sure you watch those stocks. Moderna was up 4.73% today. I jumped in some 500 DGEN lottos. Why did I do that? Last time we had a candle like this, like look at the moves it makes. So it just moves like insane. Like once it goes green, it went green here at, where did it go? Green at 344, this big green bar to rip through a bunch of fibs. 344, that run ended at 500 5 days later. So this thing as well. So we started, I'm not going to count these because these aren't really green candles. These are kind of like dojis. This is a green candle right here. We started at 375 and we closed today at 438. So I think we can get to 445 at least this week. If we get to 445 tomorrow, even those 500 calls that I called should still be a double. I'm up like 70% on them, even though time was running out there. But Moderna, everything set up on Moderna to run. I think Thursday, Biden is talking about booster vaccines. That should give it another push. Home Depot was another one on the watch list this morning. This one did not pan out. Why did it not pan out? I told you guys we needed a 331 close. Why 331? This previous resistance was 331 somewhere. Yeah, Friday's high was 331. We got above it today, but we closed below it. So wait for a 331 close on Home Depot, and we should run all the way back to these highs over here, 338.17. And then after that, we got 345.69 all-time high on Home Depot. Dash is a beautiful, beautiful setup. Look at this base. So we IPO'd, and we're still at the IPO price here. IPO high was 195.50, and the resistance I have drawn is 196.65. So today we closed at 197.12. Dash is set up to run. There's a huge short interest in this stock as well. We closed above the main level. If I seen this at the end of the day, I probably would have jumped in calls, but again, it's September. I'm loaded in Amazon, and I believe tech is the strongest sector, so I'm going to stick to tech right now. Amazon, no reason to worry. Looks like great bull flag breakthrough. If you guys go to the hourly, it looks like an even better bull flag. Was it the hourly? Yeah. So we got a cup and handle on the hourly. Came back up, retested resistance. Now we're forming a little handle. Held that huge volume shelf here at the end of the day. Great to see on the 5-minute chart, everything looks fine. Just normal consolidation. If you guys think this is bad consolidation right here, stocks don't just only go up. They have to rest. They have to consolidate. We ran from 3437 all the way to 3528. So almost 100-point move on Amazon in 2 days. And it went down like 18 points. And you guys are worried. Like, you guys have to know, stocks go up, stocks will consolidate. It's not a big deal. As long as this thing holds up over 3,500, like Ricky said, it looks fantastic to me. I'm still holding all my Amazon, haven't sold anything. Daily looks great, but the real play on this chart is the weekly and the monthly. Like I sent on the weekend, you guys, if you didn't read this, you have to do work on the weekend. I'm sorry, it's not all about partying and stuff. You want to be the best, you got to work for it. Where is this thing? I'll just show you the note right now again. Here it is. The green arrow right here. So we had a big base on Amazon, took out all-time highs, rejected the same month, came back down to the retest level. Next month, hammer candle. Next month, 27% explosion to all-time highs. So what do we have here? We have big rejection after going to all-time highs right here. Next month hammer candle, and this month if we get the same move that we did back in April, it's a 27% month and we go to all-time highs. So I am watching it. I think it's worth the risk for my account personally, just because I have a lot of profits to play with. Your account might not be set up the same way, so make sure you take profits and manage your account as you think is fit. You guys are all good traders now. By now you've joined My Stock Life a long time ago. You've been taught everything, risk management, everything. So manage your accounts as you see fit. Clover, huge, huge day. I sent this one in the morning as well. T mentioned the investor day last week. We were talking about it last night. I sent it again in the watch list this morning, and we had a 22% day. What do you guys want? Look at this, $9.45, clear resistance. Clearly broke through that this morning. Huge volume, huge uptick in buying. Everything looks fantastic on Clover. Four follow through. We closed above all the moving averages. And next level up is $11. We have to close above $11. But tomorrow is a conference. Tomorrow is GME earnings. So I think everything will fall. Just my opinion. I might be completely wrong. Every time GME reports earnings, all meme stocks fall along with it. So make sure you're aware of that. Make sure you take some kind of profits into close tomorrow. VHI, very strong start to the day, but not a strong end to the day. Looks like we might be due for some consolidation here. Huge short interest on this one. I told you guys last Friday, if we close above 1070, we should have a nice pop. I'm still in equity in this one. So we closed above 1070 on Friday. Look what happened today. We went all the way up to 1240. So you guys had $1.16 above the resistance. We bought lower, like 1020s. And I'm still holding on mine because I have equity. I'm not worried about premium kill. BTBT, complete dumper. There's something wrong with this stock. When Bitcoin runs this much and BTBT is like, it barely even gapped, didn't even gap up today, I don't think. So what this tells me, just from the price action, I haven't seen any news or anything. This company is going to do a share offering soon or dilute their stock in some kind of way. That's just what the price action tells me. Could be completely wrong, could be just consolidating. Let's see what happens. We still have 2 weeks on our options. Let's see if Bitcoin can get going again. Z, this was a play on the monthly chart. That's why I only have the monthly chart open. I think the monthly bottom is in, just from how many months of consolidation. Looking at other charts, looking at other patterns, this much consolidation is usually enough for the growth stocks. So this month, if we do get a reversal on Z, we could run all the way up to the 8-day moving average at least, which is at 109. Most likely, we'll test last month's high of 111.67. So those calls should pay anyways. We have 3 weeks on those calls. I'm not worried about those at all. I don't even look at them. VIX, I called out today. Why did I call it out? Like I told you, September is known to be volatile in the stock market. So I took some $20 calls as a hedge for September 14th. And if we do get volatile this month, it'll break through $20 easily. Also, another thing, look at it changing its trend. This is another example of changing the trend. So we had a lower high. So we had this high and this low, right? Then we had a lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low again, lower high, lower low. And now what happened here, we had 2474, 2509. So yeah, this was a lower high, but right now we just put in a low and is higher than the last one. So if we do get going and we do get volatile, it's gonna take out this level 2474 most likely. So you see what I mean? Look at this low was put in here at 1519. We put in a lower high at 2474, and now we put in a higher low at 1568. So this low was 1519, this is 1568. This time, if we are to change the trend on VIX, we have to get over 2474 to do that. That's why I took $20 calls for September 14th. Here's TAL. TAL I took because China's getting a lot of flow, and also TAL's daily chart just looks like it's been basing for a long, long time. It looks like it's going to go anytime now. This is very similar to T's VIAC play. If you don't know that one, go do some research in the Discord. It's all in there. VIAC was the same kind of setup. I might be a little premature. I just like the volume. I like the flow that was coming into it. I like the possibility of running into this gap. And we have some time. We have 2 weeks on these calls, so I'm not too worried about them. Didn't go too heavy, obviously. I'm not convinced in China. But I do like this play right now. Let's see if we can get over this volume shelf here at over 780. I think this one runs right and fills the gap to about $19. So if we get the move that is possible on TAL, those options will be a 10 bagger. So I think it was worth the risk to reward there. Jumia keeps testing 22 every single freaking day and it keeps rejecting it. But we are changing the trend. Like I said, we need to get over 2215 now. Without consolidating anymore, we need to get over 2215. 2215, 2238 is the 50-day moving average. 2215 is the resistance. So if we get through 2238, this thing's gonna fly to like $30, because that's called an inflection point. When there's two places of support or two places of resistance, if we reject off there, Jumia could be done for more weeks, a lot more weeks. We could definitely go lower. If we get through there, that's a huge bullish sign and we might absolutely rip. What else do we got? I'll do like one or two more charts. So I'll do PayPal because we won on this one. I already did Roku, and I will do Apple and then I'm done. PayPal, beautiful sell this morning. Obviously wasn't too beautiful because it ripped right back up, but look at this chart. So we jumped in PayPal 290s last week for 3-something. We were selling for 4 on this candle right here. This is where I was selling those options for 4. And it was literally the high of the day. Then we dumped down. Those options actually went red. A lot of people in here missed the sell and they were crying. You luckily got the rip back up to a high of the day. I don't think these options got much more expensive than where we sold because of the time value. I think they just stayed around that $4 level. I could be wrong. Maybe you guys sold for 5 or 6 or 8. I'm very happy for you. Congratulations. But just looking at the chart, if we sold here for 4 something, these options would have just went, they would have just bled out. It would have been like 350, 350, 360, 370, something like that, just because of time value. Maybe at the end of the day, they popped off a little bit because we got a new high of the day. But other than that, I still believe that was a great, great sell on PayPal. And I am not worried about that one anymore. Completely out of that one. Apple, all-time highs. And they're launching their new AirPods and phones in a little while. And this one had huge flow for the last 2 weeks. It's just been getting pelted with calls, like huge buys too, like 500K orders, 600K orders. And Apple, obviously, it's very hard to short the market when Apple's at all-time highs. I know that's hard to hear, but right now there's clear rotation from financials to tech. As long as financials are weak, SPY will not go up, but tech can continue to go up regardless of SPY weakness. So just remember that. Watch the four major indexes, SPY, QQQ, XLF, and IWM. See where the money is rotating. Follow the money. Play it safe. September is notoriously bad for stocks. And let's get those accounts to all-time highs, boys. Thank you guys for attending. I will see you tomorrow.